All right, I'm going. This is the feeling. They have just filled this place. This is the side of the house. Exactly, this is the kitchen, as big as it is. This knockdown one is the whole of the kitchen. Look at it. That's the kitchen here. The kitchen for the two bedroom flat. This is where they're going to put the filling. They're going to fill this place up. This is one of the two bedrooms. This is one of the two bedrooms. This is one of the two bedrooms. This is the toilet. This is the bathroom. And this is the master bedroom. It needs a lot of filling. And look at this. This is the master bedroom here. See how huge it is. The master bedroom. And then now we come to the living room of the two bedroom flat. This is the living room, and this is the visitor's toilet, and this is the veranda and the entrance to the two bedroom flat. And that tells you how much work that has been put into this in the last 14 days, in the past 12 days. This is a great job. It has been, it has taken us 12 days to put all this together, and it's been a pleasure to work like this. And this was constructed from an half plot of 30 by 80. See what is taken out of it. That's the, if you look at it again, see everything. See how deep it is. What we're going to fill up. That's it. As the living room of the self-contained. This is the kitchen. That is the bathroom and toilet there again. This is the bedroom here. Needs filling as well. It does need filling. And then we're moving to where the steps are going to be constructed. This is the steps, the staircase. Where the ground floor and the first floor will be sharing. Alright, and I've taken you around everything now. Right, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you need to speak, if you need something like this, or you want us to help you build something like this in a small space of land, do not hesitate to contact us on 0782 554 3535. Number is 0782 554 3535. And if you need to email us for an inquiry, it is D for Delta, A for Alpha, M for Mother, O for Oscar, L for Lima, 11@me.com. Damol11@me.com. Damol11@me.com. Our telephone number is 0782 554 3535, and that is the whole picture of the construction that we've been doing in the past 12 days. All right, thank you. We'll be waiting for your call or email. Thank you very much. Bye. Right, that's the video of a foundation built with raft construction. Like many of my friends, my fans that have asked me to do a video for raft construction. Any area where you find water or is a swampy land, to those of the my fans worldwide that have found themselves in a location where they bought the land and there is water, or the place is swampy, that's exactly what you need to do. What is called the raft construction. What do I mean by raft construction? You need to construct a well-planned, solid foundation where you will need to use iron rod, which you're seeing on the image there. You will get the service of a carpenter that will create a good box and the service of a welder. They will construct the box for you, and they will make sure that the foundation, when they are mixing the granite and sharp sands together, they will have created and construct iron rod that will make the solid base for the concrete to sit on. If you look at this iron rod here, this is 16 mm. I decided to choose 16 mm because what they planned for, what they told me, was to use a slimmer and thinner iron rod. Because of what you are constructing on the land, you are putting a weight on that land, and water, once it's a water foundation, you need a very, very solid thing that will contain the sharp the granite and the sand. Let me take you to the next image. That is one of the iron rods that your welder will buy. These are the way it's being delivered. But they will straighten it up, and then the next has the angle for the pillars. You are going to get to that stage where I'm going to show you where they use this ring. This is called the ring. The welder will tell you this is the ring. I'll show you one more now. That is the bending of the iron that will be used for different portion segment of the pillar of the raft. When the carpenter construct the box, this will be laid in between the box at different stages where the concrete will be poured on. The next one, this is exactly when this is how the land will be. Initially, this is the line. If you see the line there, you see the line there when they were digging the ground. This is how barren the land was before the foundation was constructed. That's how bare the ground, and that's how the laborers will dig the ground. If you are not familiar, if your contractor is talking about when you want to do the foundation, they will first and foremost line the ground, and then the laborers will dig it out like this to create space. This is this area where you see the man standing. The carpenter will put wood lie right around it before you now put in the iron rod inside that. Look at that. Look at you see the water now. If you look at this image, see where the water is, the brown water at the edge, at the bottom here. This is what we are talking about. This is the land of half plot that was sold to the owner of this land, who did not know what is going to meet there. When they started digging the foundation, they discovered that water was coming out. So here in a land like this, this is where they need to do the raft. The carpenter will create a box around the water, and when your contractor starts to pour down, they will not mix the granite and sharp sand. They will not put water at all. The granite will be poured into this water dry. The granite and the sharp sand and the cement will be poured directly without putting water. They will pour it directly into this water, and it will hold. That's where the iron rod will be laid inside this water. I was at this construction. If you look at it, they've already put it. It's been solidified. That's why they can now lay block on top of this. Go on, you will see more images. Now, if you look at the right side of this video, of this image, you will see that the box, that's the box, the carpenter, that's 1, 2, 3. Three layers of, this is 1 inch by 12. That is 1 inch by 12, three of them on top of each other. That's about the height of 3 or 4 blocks. Now, there is iron rod in between that has been laid right from the top to the end where the water is. Come with me. Look at it. Look at the iron rod that's been laid across to in between the foundation that's been dug. But they have already put concrete on the floor.
on the bed. Right. Look at that. After the foundation has been done, after the solid road, solid concrete has been put on the floor, that's a gentleman has already laid a couple of blocks on the look at that. It was when the foundation was solid, they started putting the blocks. If a contractor, look at that, look at what they have done there as well. Look at that, what the work they have done in that area. Look at it, and look at the iron rod standing. The ring I showed you earlier on was put here to hold the pillar. These are the pillars to make the foundation and to make the building to be solid. So definitely when you do a raft, you will still need columns and pillars to hold the building properly. Let me show you one more. Now look at this one. Look at this image. Look at when the raft has dried. This is solid concrete, which has nothing to do with the block. It's to prevent the water from going into these blocks. There are 1, 2, 3 coaches of blocks that is on top of the raft. Raft is complete solid concrete, granite, sharp sand, and plenty of cement. So when your contractor is talking about doing raft, this is exactly what you're going to do to destroy and to send away to prevent the water from going into the building. Look at that, look at the edges. It's a raw concrete that has dried up before they start laying the blocks. Look at that, look at the depth. Look at the height of that concrete alone before the blocks. Look at the height of that. So when you're constructing your house, you must make sure that if you're the type that bought a land, sometimes they sell you a land that is cheap because it's on water. That's why people, when they don't have any experience, whatever land they sell to them. But if you find it, it's not too late. It's not, there's nothing wrong with it if you're ready to spend money on raft. Look at the depth of the concrete. Look at that concrete there. Look at the shape of the first, that's the bedroom, the first bedroom in front there. Look at the concrete right round. Now the contractor must be able to do this. This is to tell you how solid and strong, even though it's a bungalow. But we cannot say because it's bungalow, they should not secure the land from water coming into the building. And look at the height. That's almost about 3.5 feet tall. That's more than 3 feet high. And look at a iron rod in all the places. Look at that. Yes. When we get to this stage, let me reverse a bit. Here, all these spaces that you're looking here will be filled to the top with hard laterite. This is what is called filling. This is the filling of this. That construction you saw there, we used 12 lorries of filling. So when your contractor, even if you don't do raft, you still need this filling to level up your foundation. You still need lots of, like I said, we bought almost 12. I remember this foundation very well. Almost 12 to 13 or 14 of these because of the depth, because of the height of this foundation, you need loads of hard filling. Okay, now look at that. The current price of these as at the day of recording this video is 23,000 to 24,000 of a big lorry of 20 ton. So when your contractor is talking of 20 ton, 30 tons, this is 20 ton of filling. So we use that to cap the foundation. And then look at that. When they have already poured those out into that foundation, they are now using the worker plate to ram it to prevent pocket of holes on in the ground. They're using it to prevent holes in the foundation. Look at the gentlemen, what they are doing there. That's exactly what you need to do in your construction. There is no way you want to do a foundation that has water or raft that you do not have to do this. See, you have to do that. Look at the level. They put filling right round to level, and then the next one is that black membrane, that's waterproof membrane, to prevent water from coming from the foundation to the top inside the house when you lay the blocks and when you do the blocks to the top, and then you start seeing water inside the house, even the tiles, you start seeing cracks. This is to prevent cracks in the wall all around the building when the final construction is done. And you see all those pipes, blue pipes, they are conduit pipes. that already that when the building is going up, those pipes are being taken up to the next floor, whereby you don't have to let pipes to be sticking out of the building. People don't build house these days again with pipes around the wall. Okay, this is already embedded inside the blocks, inside the foundation, to the bricks, and look at the wire net, iron rod mesh that is going to be laid on top of the waterproof membrane to prevent water from penetrating into the house and prevent the house from cracking in the distant future. So when you're doing your foundation, when you're doing your raft, all these are necessary to be done in the building. Right, that is the top of it. The top, when the earth has already been used to cap you, the filling that I told you about has already been put in down in place to cover that place. Look at it, has been used to cover the, you could see more of it. Look at it, it's filled to the brim. You need to spend money to cover it onto that. Look at another one, that's the top of the foundation, that deep foundation that you saw, that deep foundation. There's a lot of art filling that was used to cover that. Look at that, look at it, the image there. That is what you are learning in terms of after the raft construction. That iron rod, that is 16 mm iron rod. You will definitely need this for your pillars, for your foundation raft, for other things when you're doing the construction. That is the thick that you could see the images as it is. You need them for the foundation bed. Right. If you look at this image here, this is a proper. Let me bring this one, the scroll down a bit so that you can see it. Look at the box, that's the wooden inch by 12. For those of you who went to go and buy a land in a swampy place, this is the box I was talking about. The box is to separate, to make a shape of the raft. Your carpenter will need to do this right round before putting the iron rod. I will show you the next one. When you have to do your construction of the raft, you look at that. Look at the water background of the raft. You have to do this if you want to make your foundation to be essential. You are building two story or three story. This has to be done. This is a well laid iron rod for a raft construction. Let me show you that one again. You look at them. The image. Look at the height. Where the guys are standing almost to the height of the head of the welders. That constructed iron rod that you see there is a three-story building foundation that they are doing there. So, of course, there's too much water there and they have to do that. It is necessary that they have to do it, right? Let me take you to the next one and look at water under it. Look at the iron rod mesh construction for them to be able to know what they are doing to keep the weight of the building in the construction. All right, look at that. Look at the final finish. Look at the concrete. Look at the height. Look at the main seat standing. Look at the number of concrete, granite, and sharp sand that was put on this. There's no way when the flood comes that's going to pull this down. All right, there's no way that one can be brought down. If you look at it properly, that is what I'm telling you about raft construction. If you never had any idea of how raft is being constructed, look at it there. Look at it there. Now, final analysis is that they are now capping it up with solid concrete, solid granite, solid cement to prevent water from penetrating into the house. And you're going to still have loads of water on the site for them to be using all the time. There's no way this house is not solid. It's a very solid. So when you want to do your house construction, this is what you're going to looking at. You're looking at building the raft foundation, right? Don't forget to go to www.ganjua.com. That is a place where you can compare your building materials. Like I said, I have not done live video for a while. This is for a reason. I had a little bit of a challenge with Google for something I did I shouldn't do. And this is what I'm paying for it. But by the May 12th, I'll be coming back live to all my fans worldwide, from Nigeria, from Kenya, from Ethiopia, from South Africa, from all over the world, from Uganda, from Indonesia, from Japan, from Malaysia, from Dubai, from Australia, from Canada, from US, from Europe, from UK, from London, from all over the world that you have been watching my video. Thank you for your support. I can guarantee you that we are all, we hustlers all over the world, we are going to make it. We are not in the countries where we are just to complete the numbers. We are there to improve our lives. We are there to get things back across to Africa, back across home, because we have plan B, because we know we are very intelligent and resilient. We are strong. That's why we can withstand the circumstance of the countries where we are, and it is not going to be the end of it. We have been proposed to be in that country, and we are going to make it. We are definitely going to make it in a big way. All right, until I do another video, don't forget to share this video. Don't forget to good comment. Don't forget to encourage me, and we will all together make it. Until I do another video, God bless you, Lord. Merci beaucoup, all my Indonesian fans, all my fans worldwide, all my Japanese friends, all my Malaysian friends. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. God bless you. And till I send you another video. Thank you. God bless you all. Bye-bye. Bye.